Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today my video is a tutorial for you on how to make your own Roman shades out of mini blinds. I have a bay window in my kitchen that had just the cheap kind of mini blinds, and I honestly have no actual thick blinds in my house anymore. I just have curtains, and then in a couple of rooms I have the complete blackout blinds because the sun is fierce and I don't want it to be fierce in my child's room or in my room. All the other rooms just have curtains, and the sun comes in and it sets at the back of our house. It's pretty strong, around 4 or 5. And I wanted to have something that was gonna go in those three windows in the bay area. And Roman shades are pretty expensive. And so I just got this an idea thinking, I wonder if I could make my own Roman shades, because I guess that's what you do as a DIYer. I guess some people don't do that. And so I just started Googling and searching, and I kind of found some ideas. And then I just tried it on my own. So it took three sets of mini blinds. I already had these on hand. So the only thing that I bought for this project is the fabric. And the fabric I found actually came from Walmart. Some Walmarts have fabric, others do not. You can obviously get your fabric from anywhere. But I think my fabric was maybe $2.99 a yard. It was so inexpensive. And I kind of walk you through everything in the video of how I made them. And I ended up making three window treatments. It took me a day. So I just kind of spaced them out throughout the day. The only other thing you'll need is a pair of scissors, obviously. This is also a no-sew tutorial because I don't sew as of right now. I do have a sewing machine. I want to sew, but I didn't do it for this tutorial. I just used the no-sew tape with a good old iron, sewed that right in there. And you can also use the glue. I did get some fabric glue to actually glue the blinds to the fabric. You literally just modify the blinds to make a shade. And I cannot honestly believe that it turned out. There was a moment where I thought, this is going to no man's land. So I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. If you want to learn how to make your own Roman shades, then keep watching. So the first thing you're going to do is obviously pick out your fabric and then do your measurements of your window. I would recommend getting a really long ruler. I used a straight edge just because it was easier to kind of get the measurement from that and draw it on the fabric. You're obviously going to make all of your markings on the back side of your fabric, and I just used a carpenter pencil, or just a regular pencil will work, to make your markings. I wouldn't use a Sharpie or anything crazy, it'll just bleed through the fabric. And then I just made my straight edges all the way down, and I overestimated a little bit of how much fabric I was going to need, so keep a reminder of what kind of hem you would like to do. And I did a 1-inch hem on my fabric, and these are one-sided drapes. So if you have a bay window that faces the street or something where you could see it from the outside, I would do this double-sided. So just keep that in mind. Also, I would recommend ironing your fabric if you have a big seam like that. The next thing you're going to do is go through the fabric, and these are the end pieces of the slats, and you're just cutting those little cross pieces. You're not going to cut the piece that's running through the middle of the slat. That's the cord you need. That's going to be your drop cord to move this shade up and down. You're just cutting out the little tiny ladder piece. So you're leaving that piece running through the middle of the slats, and that's on each end, and you're cutting out completely the ladder that's running through the middle of the slats because you don't need that. So I started then kind of folding my fabric to get an idea of what it would look like. Again, my hems were a little smidge over an inch. I laid down the tape that I used to hem the fabric and kind of ironed everything down, so you're left with a really nice, clean, crisp, smooth kind of edge. So next you need to start kind of disassembling your blinds. You can see the middle piece is taken out, and you need to kind of pop out those little buttons. That's how you're going to kind of manipulate everything. So I pulled that one out, you can see, and you just kind of pull the cord through there so you can pull off the slats you don't need. There are so many mini blind slats. I used three at a time, kind of stacked like that, and you can see there's
5 slats to the end. And then you're just going to take that little ribbon and you're going to tie it in a knot so that you can get the blinds to hold. So you can kind of see what it looks like. Again, there's 3 slats stacked on top of each other to make it a little bit stronger. And then I just used my fabric glue on the top and the bottom. It's called the Fabri Tac. It's actually really good glue. And this gets you an idea of what my windows look like before. You can see the other mini blinds just still hanging up there, and then what the shade kind of looked like just laying down on the table right there.
So that is it. I hope that this tutorial made sense for you, that you feel like you can tackle this on your own. It's so inexpensive. If you just have some fabric laying around, you want to try it before you buy it. I would suggest trying it. It didn't take me that long, I don't feel like. So grab your fabric, slap some blinds on there and see if it works. I hope you enjoyed my tips, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.